Today in the news, we have Intel's jump towards ray tracing technology and some Radeon 7 leaks. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me just give a big thanks to our sponsor, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores, which are a great place to try out all the newest peripherals before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. Let's get started with ray tracing, but no, we're not talking about Nvidia here. In fact, we're not even talking about AMD. Yesterday, Intel launched their free open image denoiser library for ray tracing. This free library could really change the game when it comes to ray tracing for AMD and Intel, since the closest alternative is Nvidia's proprietary and closed AI denoiser. Now, ray tracing itself is super demanding to the GPU. Ideally, we would need one ray for each individual pixel on the screen, but this isn't really possible on consumer cards right now. So what they do is just decrease the number of rays, making the image look fuzzy, like what you're seeing right now. Once that's done, the image needs to be denoised or completed. And there's a few ways to do that. Battlefield 5 uses their own denoiser, since the game isn't fully ray traced, so it's passable. Nvidia, on the other hand, takes advantage of a denoiser module in their Gameworks SDK to do the job, but it's only for Nvidia titles. Here's why this Intel library is so interesting. This denoiser actually takes advantage of the CPU instruction sets instead of relying on the GPU. That means that a significant portion of the workload has been moved away from the graphics card and onto the CPU. For those who said that we don't need more than 8 cores for gaming, well, if ray tracing becomes a mainstay, and it seems like it's going to be, this might change. In fact, it might be needed, since the denoiser actually scales with core count. Oh, and for those who don't know, AMD has something called Fire Rays in GPU Open, which allows for ray tracing, and it's also open source and can work on GPUs and CPUs. In the end, we really don't need proprietary ray tracing technology, and I think that Intel and AMD are going to prove that in 2020. Moving on, we have our buddy Tom Apisak, leaker extraordinaire, with yet another leak this month. This time, it's pretty big. AMD's next high-end GPU, the Radeon 7, had its benchmarks leaked in 3D Mark and Final Fantasy 15. Let's look at the scores. In Final Fantasy, the Radeon 7 takes a huge loss, being only 300 points higher than the RTX 2070 and 1200 points lower than an RTX 2080. That's pretty bad. And that's at 1440p. The higher you go in quality, the worse it performs, getting beaten by a 1070 Ti at 1440p high quality. Now, this is an Nvidia optimized title, and it's possible that this might play a bit of a part in these scores. Looking at 3D Mark though, things take a turn where the Vega 2 card trades blows and sometimes beats the RTX 2080 in some tests. Heck, it even beats the 2080 Ti in one of them. Now, two things to clarify here. First, take this with a grain of salt. And second, the scores I'm about to compare it to are from TechRadar's review of the RTX Founders card at launch. On 3D Mark's Firestrike, the Radeon 7 scores 27,400 points versus 22,000 for the 2080 and 25,000 for the 2080 Ti. If we move to Ultra, we get a score of 6,800 for the Vega 2 card and 6,500 for the 2080. The Ti does beat the Vega card here at a score of 8,150. Lastly, we have Time Spy, where the AMD card scores a 8,700, while the RTX card beats the Radeon 7 with scores over 8,000. Now, the CPU will play a part in these scores, and of course, the factory overclocked RTX cards are going to shift the scores, but it's nice to have an idea of the numbers at least. Personally, I do think that the Radeon 7 will be game-changing for AMD, but I don't think it's going to change the game for GPUs in general. It looks like a great card, and it certainly has some honking features like the 16GB of HBM2, but I don't see gamers preferring it unless all these benchmarks are trash and the card actually demolishes the RTX 2080. What do you guys think about those numbers for the Radeon 7? Let me know down below. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news, guys. Hopefully you've enjoyed, don't forget to hit that like button on your way down to the comment section. You can click or tap right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. By the way, I'm having a hard time closing my mouth because I went to the dentist yesterday, and it just still hurts now. Anyways, take care, guys.